Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about grid integrated wind energy conversion system in MATLAB. Here you will see that this is a simulation model for a grid integrated wind energy system. This model consists of the wind energy conversion system. These are having wind turbine, PMSG, and then here we have boost converter, and this boost converter will be controlled by means of P and O BPT, and finally it will be connected to the DC link. This is the DC link. This part is known as wind energy conversion system with having PMSG generator, and then here in DC link we have inverter, single phase inverter, that going to be connected to the grid via this LCL filter, and then this inverter will be controlled by means of feed forward decoupling control concept. For that, we go to measure the inverter current, and then you have to measure the grid voltage. This grid voltage will be used for and then generate into omega t. Here you will see that here we are using PLL. Based upon the PLL, the main based upon grid voltage, this PLL will be generate omega t. That is nothing but the phase angle with respect to time. That omega t used for converting that inverter current into a DQ form. So here we are using alpha beta 0 to DQ conversion block. This is going to be convert that inverter current detail to DQ form. And also here we have another alpha beta 2 DQ conversion block. This will be used for convert that grid voltage in the VD VQ. Here we will get IDI, and here we will get VD and VQ. And here you will see that right, this is the control logic. In this control logic, here we are using DC link voltage controller, and then here we are using current control. This is current controller for DHS, and then here we are applying that feed forward decoupling control. And the addition of this output of this PA controller, and then the current from the power generation from the wind energy conversion systems is going to be act as here. A reference current for an inverter, and here you are separating that ID of the inverter current and going to process the PA controller. This will be generate some control signal. This control signal is separated from the IQ omega L, and then it's going to be added with VD. Here we will get the control signal, reference control signal in the form of VD, and here we are going to sending only real power. Here we are going to mean the reactive power equal to zero. That's why we are making IQ reference equal to 0, and it going to be compared with IQ, and it going to be process via PA controller, and then here we are applying that feed forward decoupling control concept. That means here it will be generate some control signal that going to be added with the ID omega L and then VQ, and finally you will get VD and VQ reference. So next you have to convert the VD VQ reference into alpha beta, and then you have to take only alpha quantity. And then it will be processed via PWM generator. It will be generate the switching pulse for that grid diode inverter. This pulse will be control this grid inverter for injecting the power from this wind energy conversion system to grid. And here you will see that we are having wind turbine with 3 kilowatt rating that going to be connected to the PMSG, and then output of PMSG will be converted into DC by means of this diode rectifier. And then here we have the boost converter. This boost converter will be controlled by means of P and MPPT. For which we are measuring the rectifier voltage and rectifier current. Based upon that rectifier voltage and current, here we have that P and O MPPT equations. We made several video about P and MPPT. You can check our YouTube channel for more about that. Then it will be output of P and MPPT will be duty cycle. The duty cycle is processed via this PWM generator. This PWM generator will be generated the switching pulse for this MOSFET in order to expect the maximum power from the wind energy system, as well as transfer the power to the DC. And here you will see that the power of rectifier and the power of boost converter, and then you can see the voltage of the rectifier voltage and then voltage of the boost converter. So now here we create that wind speed. Here we are changing the wind speed from 12 meter per second to 10.8 meter per second after 1 second, and then you have to check yourself. The wind turbine will be receiving 3 input: generated speed, pitch angle and wind speed. Then the speed of the PMSG will be taken here and converted into perimeter and is given to this point, and the wind speed variation will be given here. Here we are making pitch angle will be average 0. we are not really building which angle control. Now I'm going to open this scopes, and then I'm going to simulate the model. We have to see the results. Now here you see that, say this is a rectifier voltage, and then here we have a boost converter. The DC voltage here we are going to control up to 400 volt. Here you will see that it will take some time to settle to 400, and also here you will see that this is a power of rectifier and this is a power of boost converter. Is going to be maintained around the 3000 watts. And then here you will see that this is an inverter voltage and grid voltage, and then here you will see that this is inverter current, and here you will see that both inverter voltage and grid voltage both are having in phase component. What does means whatever power we are generating from the wind energy converter system, that will be sent to the point of common coupling or to the grid point. If both are in phase, we are pumping the power to that grid point. Both are having phase, and also you see the grid current also in phase with the grid voltage, because we are not using any load in between that inverter and grid. Whatever power you are generating, that going to be sent to the grid from the wind energy system. Here you will see that, so the power of the grid point, this is a reactive power of the grid. After once again that wind speed changed to 10.8 meter per second. Because of that, what happened here, you will see that there will be small oscillation in the voltage. After some time, it going to be maintained at 400 volt. And then this is a power of the rectifier, this is a power of the boost converter after reduction of the wind speed to 10.8 meter per second. And you will see that because of reduction in the power, the inverter current and grid current, you can see that current also reduced according to the power generation from the wind energy system. So now you can see that this is a real power is sent into the grid because of reduction in the wind speed. Now system working with the varying wind speed also, and also you can see that the DC voltage is maintained to 400 after changing wind speed also. And also here you will see that the grid voltage and inverter gun having in phase component, and also it having sinusoidal nature. Now I need to check the PST. Just you have to store the data first, and then you can check the PST. I think already the system having sinusoidal nature, that means inverter current and grid current are sinusoidal. Definitely the THT of the current will be less than 5% only. I will simulate for some time, and then after that I will check the THT of the inverter current or grid current. Now I am going to stop the simulation, and then I am going to check the THT. For then we need to read this power GI. And then go to tools and click effect analysis, and then here you will see you have to change the input to, and then you have to measure the THT after 0.25 seconds. Here I'm going to make the time will be 0.3 and frequency will be 50, and then same as maximum frequency I'm going to click display. Now we can see that the THT of the system is around 1.7% only, is less than 5% only. It allow and then we need to obey that IEEE standard for power quality. So this is the working model of the grid connected wind energy conversion system in MATLAB. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification of upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.